Maybe it's a prank, a YouTube thing, a social experiment. Maybe there were hidden cameras. Look. There's something written on the guard. Put it into Google Translate. Gladius Arturi Filius Tintagelli.
It's Latin. It means sword of Arthur, son of Tintagel. Who's Tintagel?
It's a place, an island off the coast of Cornwall. Some people say it's where King Arthur was born.
Alex, what if you're the only person who could have pulled that sword out? What if it's the sword in the stone?
When did the idea for this movie first come about? How long have you been working on it?
Many, many years. I've been working on this idea for many, many years. So I thought of it when I was about 12.
Right.
And I went to see E.T. and that had a big effect on me. And I also went round to a friend's house and rented the video of Excalibur, John Borman's Excalibur. This was in a time when there was no certification on VHS and kids could just rent whatever they wanted. Took a little while for the government to catch up with this new technology. So there were a few amazing years when I could rent Zombie Flesh Eaters and The Exorcist and 15 and 18 movies. One of the movies I saw was Excalibur, which had a real impact on me, not just because of the torrid sex scenes or the violence, but because it was such a fantastic, baroque, amazing movie. So when I was 12, I thought, oh, it would be cool to do a movie about a normal boy in a recognisable suburbia who discovers the sword in the stone, and I've kind of been thinking about it ever since.
What was it about this particular film and the character in particular that appealed to you?
Well, basically, I think the sitting with someone who is in love with a project and yearning, and it becomes very intoxicating, and you can fall in love with his dream and his vision. And when he showed me the visuals of Morgana, and something I had never done before, I'd never played a villain, I'd never done a children's movie. Basically, I'd check all the boxes to be the best mum of the year.
Did you know much about Joe, the director, before you got involved with this?
Yeah, I think we'd all watched Attack the Block. I love that film. I found it really, really cool.
Yeah, my brother was really into it, so when I told him about it, I never watched the film until I found out who Joe was, and then I watched the film.
Yeah.
So, working with someone who has had this idea and this dream for so long, I can imagine it's quite easy to become, what's the word, when you ownership and controlling.
Precious.
Well, yeah, it is precious. It's precious to him, but he didn't become controlling in that sense. He was very giving. It's an honour to be a part of something like this because he gave me the possibility to give him a treat or to show him different variations. And I know that he would sit down with all of the actors and give them their time to ask questions and find ideas. And so when we walked onto set, we would know what's happening and we know the arc of our story.
Yeah.
So a lot of time to the actors, which is beautiful.
He was actually a really good director because a lot of time you get intimidated, like you don't want to be with a director who's scary, and he's not scary. He's almost like a big, like one of our big brothers.
Yeah, we're going on set,
so it wasn't daunting or anything.
Yeah. Even though he's 6'3", he didn't talk about us. You know, he treated us like adults.
Everything I said about the sword is true. I can prove it. But first, we have to promise never to lie to each other ever again. To always trust each other, whatever happens. Do you promise?
I promise.
I promise too. Now don't freak out, okay? Lady of the Lake, this is Alexander Elliot. If my quest is noble and true, please return Excalibur.
It's a story that's been told lots of times and in lots of different ways. What made you kind of decide to set it around a sort of such a young cast?
Well, I'd never seen it told in this way before. And it struck me that there are elements of that myth, even if you don't know the details, that are so famous, everybody knows them, like the Lady in the Lake and the Sword in the Stone and the Round Table and Merlin. They're such powerful ideas that even if you don't know all the details around them, they work as little sort of movie devices, like blockbuster movie devices. So I thought you could do a movie where you put that stuff in modernity, and then you suddenly get all these cool collisions, like, could modern kids deal with a quest? What does it mean for a normal kid to be described as a king if he's not related to the royal family? You know, can they all unite and can they obey the chivalric code? And then just the image of an army of school kids all in armor defending their school, having this like medieval siege in their school was what got me excited.
What was it like working with such a young cast? You've got four incredibly young, talented actors leading the film.
So I got to see them on set. I went to watch them a couple of times when I wasn't shooting because I have one scene with, a couple of scenes, but the same sequence with Alex and the other ones have been captured. So we're not in the scenes together.
Sure.
And then I got to work with Patrick and Angus, which was incredible. I got to transport from one kid to the other. But they're incredible. I mean, what children? I mean, it's a hard job. And to learn lines and to act and to be vulnerable and scared and bullies, it's an incredible job. I'm very, very proud of them.
What were your favourite kind of scenes to shoot on? I think maybe start with you.
My favourite ones, I liked being mean, that was fun. And like in the scene when I was fighting Louis with the big lake scene where Lance ruins everything, that was really fun because just fighting, it's decent.
I think my favourite scene to shoot was the car chase scene. That was really fun. Yeah, we were in the studio and we were on a platform and there was a shell of the car that you see in the film. We were all strapped in and surrounded by a green screen. Yeah, it was just really fun to, yeah, and there was the old lady that I only met for like 2 minutes before sitting on her lap. So it's just, yeah, it was just really funny, but yeah, good scene.
I'd have to say Morgana's Lair, you know, because it was literally like a playground that I could play in and I was on like a harness. I could just like explore and walk through and I had to like slip down, yeah, it's cool.
And I just liked all the intimate scenes between the characters because this was the very big contrast from the stunt scenes. And so it was nice to explore our actual characters that way.
To learn the basics of swordcraft, you will need a weapon each. A simple duplication spell for metallic objects should suffice. What are you doing, boy?
I do magic tricks for a hobby, but I'm no good at duplication illusions. So I'm going to video what you do and try and copy it.
I'll be most impressed if you succeed.
Wow!
Now, you have an army to fight, a demon to slay, a country to save.
Now, the casting of Merlin was an interesting one as well, because you've got, on the one hand, you've got the young Angus Henry kind of doing the young version, and then Patrick Stewart, of course, as well, the legendary Patrick Stewart. How did he get involved with the film?
Well, we knew there was an opportunity to cast a big star, because like you say, it's mostly these new faces, but it's always good to have a star to make people feel comfortable. My idea for Merlin was to have him age backwards, and for him to be able to transform his older self or his younger self, so it was always going to be a shared role. And Sir Patrick Stewart was one of the first people I thought of. You know, he's never done anything like this before. He has that star power and he's an amazing actor. He happened to be in John Borman's Excalibur, so it was kind of a cool full circle for him to come. And we sent him the script. He read it, he liked it. I went to his house. We talked for hours, discussed the part, talked about all sorts of stuff. And he was up for doing it, which was great.
What was it like kind of seeing this whole thing back for the first time?
It was overwhelming,
yeah.
But I was really proud. I mean, I'm grateful and I feel privileged to be a part of something like this and for people to recognise me. Yeah. But I was proud of myself for actually being able to film something like this.
I thought Merlin was supposed to be an old man. You look about 16.
An ingenious alias in order to monitor you incognito. You will need to assemble a team of knights.
Arthur's knights gathered at a round table so that they were all equal. And look. Quick, Bettis, lift up the flaps. See?
Oh my God, you're such a nerd.
This is destiny.
The five of us won't stand a chance on our own. We need to raise an army.
Who will join us?
How humiliating.
This is instead of lessons today.
Awake, my warriors. This is the worst and best and most
most terrible, excellent thing that's ever happened to me. Where did you learn how to drive? Mario Kart?